Hi, I'm Dirk from Air Games Europe, and today we're going to talk about the FX Impact. The FX Impact has been FX's flagship for quite some while now, and this is the Mark II with the Power Plenum in the Bronze Edition. Usually it's in black, but this is one of the latest editions you can get them in. FX Impact has been quite a popular platform, mainly because it's completely adjustable. You can change the caliber, the power settings, regulator settings, anything you see outside of this block can be changed. Now, what does that mean? It means that you can change it according to your needs. May you be a sports shooter, a blinker, hunting, pest control, whatever. It can all be suited to your needs. I'm going to give a quick overview, not too much in depth. FX has made their own videos with more in-depth controls, how to change anything. I will link down in the description where you can see more of them. Because they can explain everything 10 times as better as I can. So today is more like an overview. Now to start off, I mentioned that you can change the power on this. In here, you have the power adjustment, and surprisingly enough, you can use it to change the power. It uses small lines as an indicator, and I will give more of a close-up in a while to give you more of an in-depth view of how this works. On the other side, you have your power adjustment for the hammer tension, and in conjunction, you can tune this rifle to give you the right pressure behind each pellet. Inside the trigger guard, there's an entry for an Allen key, where you can change the pressure of your regulator. Now, what the regulator does is quite simple. It makes sure that behind every shot you take, there's the same kind of air pressure. In contrary to a normal air gun that uses no regulator, when you have no regulator, every time you shoot, there becomes less pressure in the bottle, as you would expect. Now, if you have less pressure in the bottle, you also have less pressure behind your pellet. So every time you shoot, your next pellet will come a little bit lower. Now with high pressures, you don't really see this, but the lower pressure you have, the more you see a drop in your pellets. Now with this regulator, it stays constant until you have reached the point below your regulator pressure, and then you see a drop off. Now from that point, you should stop shooting, because at that point you can also, besides damage your regulator, it's just better to start filling your air rifle again. So as mentioned, this rifle also has the Power Plenum. This is one of the latest additions to the FX Impact. And what it means, the plenum is the amount of air volume that's used behind every shot. So now you have a larger plenum, which means that when you shoot, the amount of air that comes out of your regulator will be larger, and you can have more powerful shots. Now this can be used in two ways. One way is when you use heavier pellets or slugs, for example. You have more mass behind your pellet, so if you use a plenum, you have more power. On the other opposite side of the story, you can also have a lower regulator pressure, which causes you to have more power due to the plenum, but because you have a lower regulator pressure, you have more shots out of one fill. Talking about the fill, the bottle is a 480cc carbon fiber bottle, which causes the rifle to have a very, very light weight. This rifle is a very comfortable 3.2 kilograms. And most of the weight is distributed around the center and the back, so when you have it shouldered, it's really nicely distributed. The barrel, the FX Impact has a quick changing barrel system. Not that quick, but it's quick. You can take out the barrel and change it to a longer barrel if you want more velocity, or a shorter one if you want to have a more compact package. You can also change its caliber from 4.5, also known as 177, to 5.5. 0.22, 6.35mm, 0.25, which is this version, 7.62mm, excuse me, or a 0.30, or a 9mm, 0.35, and you can change it to those calibers. You can also change the liner inside your pellet, inside your barrel, excuse me, because then it can be more suited to your type of pellet or slug. The liners inside these barrels are smooth twist. This is the Smooth Twist X, which is the latest variant. Which is the good part about this is that in the beginning, it's almost a smooth barrel. This causes the pellet to have less friction when it goes through them, and they can go faster without using too much air. Now on the end, it starts to get a rotation, and this makes the pellet to become more stable in flight. And because of that, it uses less air to generate more power, and you're more efficient, and you have more constant shots. Now, on the side, you have the pressure gauge for your bottle. This bottle is a 250 bar pressure, and on the back you have a pressure gauge for your regulator. You should not shoot your rifle if the pressure on this gauge is lower than the gauge on your regulator. On top, you have a 22mm Picatinny reel for adding your scope or other type of optics. On the side, you have the same type of reel for adding lights, laser, whatever kind of accessory you would like. And on the bottom, currently I have a bipod, but there's also a small reel for bipods or anything else you would like, which can also be changed out, for example, if you would like a longer reel with this Saber Tactical reel, which you can switch out and have a very long reel, so you can put this bipod on front or have different kind of lights, you decide. On the end of the barrel is shrouded, which also causes its own to be a little bit of their own suppressor. They've added their own suppressor, it's quite a simple one, but surprisingly effective. Below this is half inch UNF thread, which can be used to attach any different kind of suppressor, like this Sumo. Dunhill suppressors are quite an often popular choice between the FX brands, so why not? Inside here you have the trigger, which is fully adjustable, it's a match grade trigger. You have an AR-15 style grip, which can be switched out to any kind of style of attachment. The stock is also adjustable in height, up or down, and you can also take it off and attach a whole different kind of stock. Same for the cheek rest, same for the rail, everything can be switched out. The rifle uses a side lever, which is very comfortable and very easy to use. And you can decock them. Then now for a close-up. On the side, as mentioned, the pressure gauge for the bottle. On the rear, the pressure gauge for the regulator. On front, you have the power adjustment. You can twist it clockwise and counterclockwise to change your the opening of the valve, and with this you generate more or less power. On the side, you have your hammer tension adjustment, or rotate it, and you can change to higher or lower hammer pressure. The higher pressure, the harder the hammer hits the valve, and you generate more pressure out of one valve strike. Combined with the power adjustment, you can really tune this rifle down. Inside the trigger guard, you can have access for the Allen key to change your regulator. For the magazines, the FX Impact uses their Sideshot high capacity magazines. They are, of course, still available in all different calibers. The 4.5 or 177 caliber has 38 shots. The 5.5mm or 0.22 has 28 shots, the 6.35 or 0.25, this one has also 28 shots, the 7.62 or 0.30mm version has 32 shots, and the 9mm has 18. To load this magazine is rather easy. You take your slug or pellet of choice, rotate the top, take off the cap, lid, take one of your pellets, rotate the magazine, and place that pellet in the first chamber. Now it won't rotate back and you can start loading your magazine. When you're done, you've done them all, you take back the lid, put it back in place, and rotate it back. And you're all done. Now the most anticipated part of the video, the actual shooting. Currently, mounted on this the mounted optic is in the ATN X-Sight 4K Pro 3 to 14 times. The reason I mount this is for two options. One is a very popular option for day and night shooting, and because I'm very lazy and you can zero this reticle within one shot. That's why. Now, before we all start shooting, we should all remember two things. One, read the manual. Put on your goggles. Very safe. I've loaded the magazine with JSB Exact King Heavies in 6.35. To load the magazine, take your side lever all the way to the back with the transparent side towards yourself. There's a small guide that allows you to have more easy access and until it snaps in place. There's a little tab here, so when you pull it out, you first have to press the tab and then it comes out all in one. When you're ready to shoot, close the lever, take it off safety, and fire your first shot. Now, the cocking lever on this thing is very smooth. You can do it with your pinky if you want to. There's something you see coming back very often with FX air rifles. They're very smooth to use. It's lovely. Now I've mounted this Donyavel Sumo, which is a very powerful suppressor. And of course you can hear that it is not the gun that is making the sound. It's the pellet catcher, which is not really made for these kind of powers, and it's way too close, as you can probably see all kinds of lead shattering around me. To keep in mind, this is a long range precision air gun. You can see videos of people going way beyond 100 meters without any problems. If they know what they're doing, they have it tuned right, you can do remarkable things with this air rifle. FX really has set a high bar for other companies with this air rifle, and I would really like to see where the industry is going after this one. Well, that kind of concludes this entire video. Remember, stay safe while doing this, but have fun. And I'll see you in the next video.